Now we have placed our mullions, we have created, sorry, our curtain wall. We have to make sure always that we know that we can select any single part. You can select the mullion itself. This one, for example, the panel. Okay, you can select any one of these parts and do whatever you want. Delete. Yes, I'm hover overing this part. Type, then I select the panel. Okay, the thing that this panel is bent. Okay, I can't delete it. I can't change anything here. Let's try to change it. For example, I want it as a stack panel. It's changed now because this one is not bent. Sometimes when you select a wall or a curtain panel, it gives you a small bend on the panel itself. When you have the small bend over the panel, so it's bent. Just click over that pin, or just click on an icon here which is unpin, UP, okay? Then you are free. You can just change whatever you want. That means if you select any panel, you can choose any type of the panels here that you have, and then you will have it repeated over your panels. If you select anyone else or any other panel, for example, this one, now I have the ability to select it and choose, for example, let's say this type. So now I have a different thing. You can choose any panel family and assign it as a panel for this place. You can also select the mullion itself. This is the bin that I was talking about. If you have this bin, so you can just unbin it or just click on this icon. Now it's unbinned. You can change the family. For example, I want it square. Now I have this one square and this one circular. Fine. You can also select it and delete it. You don't want to see it here. So this is the mullion and this is another one. And here you have only the division of this panel. Fine. That's the way of changing any single part or editing any single part of your curtain panel or curtain wall. Okay, now you can also change or edit the profile of this wall. Double click on this wall, you can change the profile. If you remember in the previous class, we have talked about changing the profile of a wall, right? Draw the profile that you need, slice here, trim here, this to this, and this guy to this guy, and just click OK. Now you have this opening inside your wall. Fine, it's easy, right? And don't forget that you can just select the wall, edit type, and you can duplicate and change everything. Here you we have choose the fixed distance, but actually you have more than one option. You have fixed distance for a certain distance or dimension between the mullions and the grids. And here you have the fixed number if you have a certain length of your curtain wall, and you just know that you have 3 mullions. But you don't know what are the exact distances between these numbers, or sorry, mullions. So you can just click on fixed number and it will divide it. Maximum spacing. I just want the maximum space between these mullions to be 2 meters. It will automatically generate the mullions for the best dimension between the mullions to get a fixed number of mullions with the fixed dimension of the mullions. So if it's, for example, 5 meters, and you give maximum 1 meter for the distances. Maybe it will give you 5 distances, so 4 mullions and 1 meter between each other, or sorry, each two. Fine. So it will automatically calculate. And the latest one is the minimum spacing. I just want the minimum spacing between these mullions to be 1 meter, so it will not be 19, for example, or 90. It will always be 1 meter or higher, or larger dimensions. Fine. That's about the settings for the curtain walls.
Just for mullion size.
It will consider the mullion size with the dimension. So if it's 1 meter, it will be center 1 meter, or from the face of the mullion to the face of the mullion. Fine.
How to select one straight panel?
You don't have one straight panel. You have more than one panel on the same line.
For example, in horizontal, you select the top column to change the
Sometimes you can go to an elevation and make a window selection like this. You will select everything. If you are in an elevation, for example, let's select this one and let's isolate the selection. Now I have this only here. I can just do this. But now I have selected the panels and the mullions in between. So I can go to filter. Under filter, I can just keep the panels. I didn't explain the filter yet, so that's why I didn't talk about this. Fine? Okay, that's about the selection of a certain row in the curtain wall. Fine? That's all about the curtain walls. Now, what if you need to draw a curtain wall on a curve? A curvy curtain wall. So go to the plan for, or not in plan, in 3D we can do that. We can just select this wall and let's select the empty type again. Okay, I will click on this arc here to draw this arc. Don't forget that you can give this information while drawing. Click on this part, this type, and then this type. What did I get? I get, sorry, the wall. But it's straight, but the constraint is arc, right? Why I have got this straight one while I'm drawing the curvy one? Because I don't have any mullion to give you the curvy shape. In order to get a curve in the in the curtain walls, you need this these vertical divisions, right? So that you will have the panels beside each other and it will give you, it will generate the arc. How to do that? You can even to select the mullion, the grids from this panel and give vertical mullions, one, sorry. It's not giving me, let's go for this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, for example, as much as you need, fine? Then go to the 3D, you will have your arc. Once you have vertical grids, you can do the arc or the curve walls. Fine. That's about the curtain walls in Revit. Don't forget that you have the ability to select any of your elements, and you will get all the properties in the properties palette, right? So base constraint, we have talked about that. It's the bottom of the wall, and if you have an offset, for example, 1 meter, it will offset from the base constraint by 1 meter. If you have a top of a top constraint, now I want it, for example, unconnected, I can give a certain height. I want it to be connected to the roof. Now it will change the height of this curtain wall, so it's telling you that this horizontal curtain pan grid and mullions will be deleted because the height does not reach this level. I will click delete elements. Fine, and always please read the messages that Revit pops when you are pops up when you are working on Revit. Fine, let's go down a little bit. Room bounding, I will talk about it later. Down, down, down. You have an offset for the grids. Where to start the grids? If it's starting from this point, so I have an offset. I can give it an offset. It's starting from the beginning here, right? But it's not enabled, because I'm using an empty panel and I'm adding the vertical mullions manually. So I'm placing the mullions in the place that I want. Fine? And these are the options, you can browse them when you are working. Fine? Again, edit type, duplicate, you can do it, you can rename, you can give all the data or the settings that you need. The latest panel here is the identity data. The identity data is the place where you add texts or specifications, descriptions, annotation things for your elements or objects. Fine? We'll talk about it later when we are working on tagging or keynoting or something like that. That's about the walls. I still have one extra type or one more type of walls, that when you have a wall that is combined of more than one type. For example, the wall from 0 to 1 meter is 40 millimeter thickness, and then is 20 millimeter thickness for 2 meters, for example, and then another 1 meter is 20 or 30 millimeter, centimeter thickness. How to do that? You can do each one separate, and you can do one stacked wall. How to do the stacked wall, which is a combination of more than one type of walls that are combined vertically. To do that, just draw any wall, for example. Okay. In the type selector, you can go down to get to the stacked wall. Fine. I have just selected any of the walls. I can go to the type selector. I can go down till I get the stacked wall category. Under the stacked wall category, choose the type that you want. If you don't have the type, choose any one, and then edit type to duplicate. Again, select any of your walls, and you can see now, this is the wall. The thickness is larger, a type of finishing, a sweep, more than one type of wall are combined vertically. How to do this? Select, choose the type of the stacked wall that you want to need. If you don't want to use any of the existing types, you can just select the wall and choose any of these types and click on edit type. Duplicate, let's name it stacked wall. Maybe it's an interior one. And you can just give the description that you need. In the structure, you can edit type. Now you don't have all the options of the wall. So remember when we access to the structure of the wall, we have materials, we have identity, we have blah, 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 blah. Here, no. You have the ability to select what are the types of the walls that you are combining. So, in the type selector, you have many types of walls, right? You have created some. You have already prepared many type of walls. Now you can select them here. If you have the types prepared, so you can select them here. Let's say that I want my first wall to be, for example, 1 meter height. Okay? Let's say it's a zero offset now. Fine. And the type I want it to be, for example, this one, blaster whatsoever. I want the second one to be 1.5 meter height. And I want this type, for example. Let's go for the third one. I want 4 millimeter finish. No, it's the same. I will select another one, maybe this one. I will select from here. I want it to be 1 meter also. And the latest one is variable. Why is it variable? Because it will take the rest of the height, the remaining height, and it will be given this type of walls. Offset, it will offset your walls from the center of the wall. I can preview. I can give it an offset, for example, let's say 0. Now it's with a 0 offset. 0, now it's another 0 offset. Fine. These are my types. If I change any of these types, it will be changed here. Sometimes it's overlapping or it couldn't be created out of this type. It will tell you what is the issue. You can deal with that issues. Fine. I've chosen everything. Let's click on OK. Click on OK and click on OK. OK. Now you have your types selected or created. Fine. It's the stacked wall. And to be honest, you will not face a lot of issues to use stacked walls. It's not that huge deal. Fine. These are the types of wall that you are enabled, or sorry, you have the ability to use in Revit 2017. So you have the options and you can combine them and prepare or sorry, complete your projects. Fine? Okay. Let's go to our plan again. Delete, 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 delete. Which one? Okay, how to combine the curtain wall and the wall in the same time, in the solid wall you mean. Okay, let's go to the ground floor plan. Now I have this wall and I need to add a curtain wall here and I wanted to cut it automatically to give you the opening. Fine, let's do that. Just click on the wall, create similar for example, choose the type of curtain walls that you need. If the type that you are selecting has this option enabled, automatically embed. Click OK. Then draw the curtain wall in the center of the solid wall. It should be drawn in the center of the solid wall. If not, draw it anywhere else. Then align, AL for align. Click on the center line of the solid wall, and then click on the center line of your curtain wall. It will automatically open your solid wall and gives you the voids. Go to the 3D now. You have it here. You can just change the height, for example. It will automatically close the extra height. Fine? That's the case. Any questions? Do you want to try the stacked wall? Okay, just create any type of stacked walls, please. But make sure that, please guys, make sure that you have the ability to combine the types that you have here. If you want to create any stacked wall and to use any type of walls inside the stacked wall, for example, you go for this stacked wall and click on edit type, WA, walls, stacked wall, edit type. The types that you have the ability to use here are the walls that you already have in the type selector. If you don't have the type created here, go to any wall, any type of walls, okay, and create the new type that you need, then you have the ability to use it in the stacked wall. Fine? Any questions? Any questions, guys? Okay, open your system, please, and create one or two stacked walls.